Hi guys. So I have a pleasure today to make an interview with Laura Hogan. She's a director, search director, right?
Yeah,
at Rice Media. Yeah. So tell me a little bit about what you do at Rice Media. What your what your real focus?
So at Rice, we're in Birmingham, which you can probably tell from the accent. And I look after the search team, so that's the SEO, the PPC, the social media guys, and we just work across a number of national and local and international clients, just getting improving their rankings, traffic and revenue. Yeah.
Okay, cool. And so what about lean building? You're going to talk today about lean building and about lean building processes, and what skills do you think are most critical, important, which most commonly overlooked when it comes to link building?
I think time is one of them. I think people just assume that link building is quick, that it's easy. And actually, the most important thing with link building is you've got to have the time to put into it. It's not like years ago where we could go and do splatter 50 comments in a day and you've got all those links from it. You have to take the time
it's
to
build.
It's
called spam right now.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. So we have to take the time to build relationships now. We have to take the time to build some really good content too that people actually want to link to. So I think that's the most undervalued part of it, the actual time it takes.
But what about skills? I mean, like, do you need to know psychology, for instance, or it's okay to be just an SEO guy? Which is normally, like, SEO guys, they tend to be not really communicative.
Yes. I think you definitely need to be a people person to do link building. Mm. You need to have the personal side to you. Like, I actually find that a lot of our guys that do outreach, before they got into the industry, they did a lot of customer service work or a lot of bartending. Mm. And the confidence they get from that really helps when they're talking to people for link building, especially picking up phone.
Calling. Call it, yeah.
Yeah,
I don't like it, actually. I only do like emails. But I should try. I mean, like, if you work with journalists, for instance, yeah, it's like, you know, you should do that.
Yeah.
But if we talk about bloggers and, like, you know, people that just write on the web, I think it's okay to do it via email.
100%, yeah. Like, if it's somebody's full-time job, then they're more likely to answer the phone. If it's something that they're doing as a passion, you know, they might have a full-time job too. So, yeah.
Yeah. So, I have a question about your ducks.
My little pups.
Yeah, your lovely one. Actually, I have enjoyed your Instagram. You have so many lovely photos.
Yeah.
So, am I right that it's Milo and Max?
Yeah, Milo and Max. And Milo is the beagle and Max is the cocker spaniel. Yeah.
Oh, lovely. So, well, have you ever tried to use your ducks in outreach campaigns?
I actually have, and I do quite often. So, whenever I'm talking to somebody for the first time, if I'm introducing, that's kind of my in. So I'd sometimes, so some of the guys, they use football teams. I'm like, have you got a dog? You know, I've got two dogs, here's my dogs. And it works, it breaks the ice. It's a good way to start. And then it's like, oh, send me a picture. And then you can start building that conversation with them, making friends that way. And then because you get on a personal level, it tends to work really well for outreach.
Yeah, it's all about finding something similar between you and someone else. Well, I should use my horse more, actually.
See? Exactly. Yeah. It's a really good way.
I might ask him because he's just kind of shy. But if I can coordinate with him, then it can go viral.
You can get a picture of him and be like, look, here's my pet. Everybody loves animals.
Everyone has a horse. So that's mine.
Why not?
Everyone was like, no. Okay. Okay, but let's talk about reading.
Yes.
Since I hope you also enjoy it. You love reading, right?
Yeah. So I use an app called Pocket, which I've got on my phone. And then it just pings through any really good articles, particularly picks up ones from Twitter.
Yeah.
And then so in the morning, I just have a quick read of it at lunch. And then kind of throughout the day, I have a quick look on there and it'll bring up anything that's kind of in the trends that I like.
Mm-hmm. And what was the most recent piece was that was really impressed you? I was like, oh, wow, that's something incredible.
I actually read this really good PR campaign from Anne Summers last week, and they were using, they were kind of setting up this challenge for spring to kind of, you know, 30 day sex challenge, but the way they did it was amazing. So they used the old kind of art models you used to have in school, so they made it quite funny and when it's quite a taboo subject. But they got such good coverage for it as well. But just the way they went about it, it was really good. Like, it had this whole sense of competition behind it. Like, it was breaking the boundaries. And it was just such a fun piece. I thought they did really well there.
Yeah, yeah. That's actually, that's a little bit remind me that was really, like, impressed me. I recently seen a new ad that was produced by Grammarly, and they were using a combination of Tinder and type that you make when you send messages on Tinder, and with the help of Grammarly, you can just, you know, make it much smoother and make a better impression.
They're so my favorite kind of PR campaigns, when they're a little bit fun, they're hitting on a topic that people might be scared to talk about, but they do it in such a good way that it's so accessible.
No, it was lovely. I think that was among the ads that I really enjoyed and watched till then, because normally you're like, YouTube, you are just forcing me to do that. Yes. I don't want to do that.
too many sometimes, isn't there?
Okay, thank you very much, Laura. Thank you for being with me today. That was such a pleasure, and hope you're going to join Digital Olympus, maybe testing out some editions. Magal speakers?
Yeah, of course. Awesome. Thank you so much for asking me and having me.
Yeah.
And good luck with the rest of the day.
Yeah. Thank you.
No, see you later.
Have a nice day.